Cornea verticillata manifests as opaque golden or grey deposits that describe a spiral pattern in the basal epithelial layer of the cornea. They are normally located in the lower interpapillary portion, oriented clockwise. In the literature, we can find other names for cornea verticillata. The best known are vortex keratopathy, spiral keratopathy, and Fleischer vortex. The most important associations are two, with amiodarone and Fabry disease. In fact, 90% of those affected by this disease have cornea verticillata. In addition to these two pathologies, other associations have been described that we will show you exhaustively listed at the end of this video, and that will help us to establish the differential diagnosis of the cause. Cornea verticillata is usually asymptomatic. Patients have no visual complaints or ocular discomfort. Rarely, patients may see blue-green rings or halos around the lights. In patients with cornea verticillata and decreased visual acuity, concomitant with the use of amiodarone or tamoxifen, we must rule out optic neuropathy as the main cause of visual impairment. And if visual acuity is affected by the use of chloroquine, hydroxychloroquine, or tiloron hydrochloride, we must rule out retinal toxicity. The vortex or spiral pattern of cornea verticillata results from the natural centripetal migration of the corneal epithelial stem cells, which are located in the sclerocorneal limbus and laden with deposits, transit from the limbus to the corneal center through as the epithelium undergoes its natural growth and repair. Drugs produced by cornea verticillata share cationic amphiphilic properties that allow them to readily enter lysosomes in the basal epithelial layer of the cornea, where they bind to cellular lipids, resulting in drug lipid complexes that are resistant to enzymatic degradation and therefore accumulate as deposits in the cornea. On the other hand, endogenous causes of vortex keratopathy include lysosomal storage diseases. It is usually detected during a routine eye exam because it does not usually produce symptoms. The diagnosis is simple, by observing with a slit lamp and observing the deposits arranged with the characteristic spiral pattern. A detailed medical history should be taken to identify possible underlying causes. There is no recommended treatment for cornea verticillata. In most cases, it does not require treatment, as it does not cause any significant vision problems. However, if the condition is caused by medication, the drug may need to be adjusted or stopped. After months or years of stopping the offending drug, most of these deposits resolve automatically. For these two groups of patients, those who may present with optic neuropathy or retinal toxicity, it will be necessary to consider reducing the dose of the drug or changing to a different drug if there is impairment of visual acuity. Patients with cornea verticillata should also have regular eye exams to monitor their condition and make sure it does not progress to more serious eye problems. Here you can see medications that have been associated with cornea verticillata. And here you have listed other causes, preferably endogenous, that have been associated with this pathology. In conclusion, we can say that cornea verticillata is a relatively common lesion that can be caused by certain medications or underlying medical conditions. Although it usually does not cause significant visual problems, it is important to follow up in all cases and rule out retinal or optic nerve complications if visual acuity decreases.